identifier that before.
Thank you.
Mr. President, today the Supreme Court reaffirmed the right to an abortion. What's your reaction, sir?
Chris, he's having a press conference
8
tonight.
8 o'clock tonight.
He'll tell you tonight.
8 o'clock tonight.
How about the Rogers Commission? You going to endorse all their findings, sir?
8 o'clock tonight.
See any new astronauts here, Mr. President?
The military. But the Army at that time didn't seem interested either. Few people seemed willing to believe in the importance of the work of the Wright brothers. Then one week, two men from overseas came to Ohio, troops. The Englishman said to the Wright brothers, his country would also be a reward. He said England would be willing to pay whatever the Wright brothers wanted, the rights to the airplane. Someday, our Army will be interested too. Not too long after that happened, Theodore Roosevelt was reading an article to reporters gathered right across the Potomac River, right close to here, at Fort Myer. And the Wright brothers flew their plane for everybody. He said, Wright brothers, have you sold the rights of this plane to any foreign government? Orville Wright simply said this, General, we're Americans, and we want our country here. You have the best chance of anywhere in the world to be a national.
And scientific achievement. But you know, each one of these air and spaceships needed a pilot.
We're going in with a space program and we're being men, which I'm going to tell you.
Their commitment to act and one flag, one day. In fact, it's simple. Because with their memory in mind, we're not only going to do everything we plan to do before, we're going to do it better. You know, after the Shuttle disaster, many supportive calls and letters flowed into the young astronaut council from young people like this, we wouldn't be here today. We should honor the great astronauts who seek their dream, yet another. I want to join the young astronaut program and find.
Even made me feel that I qualify for the young one.